Aminocaproic acid is used to help control bleeding. Due to a condition where your blood does not clot the way it normally should, fibrinolysis. This may cause serious bleeding after certain surgeries or in certain conditions, such as bleeding disorders, liver disease, cancer. Aminocaproic acid works by helping your blood clot normally. It belongs to a class of drugs known as antifibrinolytics. Indications. Aminocaproic acid has received approval from the Food and Drug Administration for the therapeutic management of acute hemorrhages caused by elevated fibrinolytic activity leading to surgical complications after cardiac surgery, hematological disorders, hepatic cirrhosis, and neoplastic disease. Indications also include the treatment of surgical and non-surgical hematuria. Aminocaproic acid has been used off-label for the following indications: prevention of gentle bleeding after gentle procedures in patients with hemophilia A. Intracranial rebleeding prophylaxis after recent aneurysmal subarachnoid hemorrhage. Prophylaxis of secondary ocular bleeding in the sitting or traumatic hyphema. Angioedema prophylaxis in patients with hereditary angioedema. Surgical bleeding prophylaxis for a cardiopulmonary bypass as monotherapy or in combination with desmopressin. How to use? It is available as oral solution, oral tablets, and intravenous solution. Aminocaproic acid can inhibit both the action of plasminogen activators and also plasmin activity to a lesser extent. It should not be administered without a definitive diagnosis confirmed by laboratory results in the active of hyperfibrinolysis. Oral dosage. For the management of acute bleeding caused by hyperfibrinolysis, the recommended oral dosage is 5 grams the first hour, followed by 1 to 1.25 grams per hour for 8 hours, or until bleeding is under control. The maximum daily dose for both oral and intravenous formulations is 30 grams. Intravenous dosage. The intravenous dosage is 4 to 5 grams over 1 hour, followed by 1 gram per hour. Continuous infusion is 50 ml of diluent for 8 hours, or until achieving bleeding control. It is recommended to dilute the initial intravenous dose 4 to 5 grams of aminocaproic acid in 250 ml of 0.9% sodium chloride injection, 5% dextrose injection, or lactated Ringer's injection. Rapid infusion of the undiluted drug is not recommended and may result in hypertension, bradycardia, and or arrhythmia. Contraindications. Aminocaproic acid use is contraindicated in the following cases: active intravascular clotting, disseminated intravascular coagulation. Aminocaproic acid may be used in these scenarios if there is concurrent heparin administration. Clinicians can apply the following tests to differentiate between DIC and primary fibrinolysis. Platelet count is typically decreased in DIC but is usually normal in primary fibrinolysis. Euglobulin clot lysis is normal in DIC, however it is abnormal in primary fibrinolysis. Protein and paracoagulation test is positive with DIC, however it is negative with primary fibrinolysis. Aminocaproic acid may cause intrarenal obstruction, glomerulocapillary thrombosis, clots in the ureters or renal pelvis, in patients with upper urinary tract bleeding. Therefore, until possible benefits outweigh the risk, it should not be used in patients with hematuria of upper urinary tract origin. Warnings. Stop using aminocaproic acid and call your doctor at once if you have unexplained muscle pain, sudden numbness or weakness, tingling or cold feeling in an arm or leg, trouble breathing, a sudden cough or a sudden chest pain. Aminocaproic acid side effects. Aminocaproic acid is generally well tolerated. Reported adverse effects include malaise, myalgias, renal impairment, seizures, hypertension, bradycardia, thrombosis, edemas, and injection site reactions. Aminocaproic acid very less often may also cause gastrointestinal symptoms including nausea and diarrhea. There are also reports of nasal congestion and conjunctival suffusion. Following long-term aminocaproic acid administration, skeletal muscle weakness with necrosis of muscle fibers has been reported rarely. Symptoms range from myalgias with weakness fatigue to a severe proximal muscle myopathy resulting in rhabdomyolysis, myoglobinuria, and or acute renal failure. Therefore, muscle enzymes, especially creatine phosphokinase, can be elevated and should be monitored in patients on prolonged treatment. Aminocaproic acid use should be discontinued if it elevates CPK in patients.